Hey y'all, it's Megan. If you're returning to my channel, welcome back, and if you're new, welcome aboard. So, I am finishing up wedding month, as I have always called August. I'm finishing it up by talking about how the Disney weddings are working now in Florida. A couple of years ago, I did a video about the wedding packages that they had available for the Disney fairy tale weddings in Florida, and that is since not a thing anymore. So, I am gonna kind of run through the way that the weddings are working now. Once again, this is only for Florida. That's the only one that I'm really familiar with. So if you want information on weddings at Aulani or at Disneyland or any of the other Disney properties, make sure that you do check out the Disney Fairy Tale Weddings website. I'll link it down below for you. And they have all the information there, and they are really willing to work with you anytime you contact them and ask them questions. So if you're interested in a Disney wedding, no matter where you're looking at having it, definitely do contact them and check out the website. So that being said, let's talk about the fact that there are no packages anymore. There used to be three for Disney weddings at Disney World in Florida. You would have the Escape, Memories, and Wishes packages, which kind of went up in the amount of money that they cost, and also in the customizability. Is that a word? The ability to customize individual things that you wanted within your wedding. So that is not a thing anymore. And now it's all based simply on where you have your event and what the day and time of your event is. So every location that you can have your wedding at has an event minimum, and they kind of run in ranges, and I've got them broken out for you, and I will tell you what those minimums are for all of the locations at Walt Disney World. But before I do that, I want to explain what these event minimums cover. Minimums cover your food and beverage, which is everything that you eat or drink while you're there. Anything that your guests have, that is the cake, that is the food, whether you do plated or buffet style meal, breakfast, brunch, lunch, dinner, no matter which meal you're having with your wedding, all of that goes towards the food and beverage. Any drinks, any champagne, any open bar, any of that kind of thing goes towards your food and beverage. Your decor, which includes, you know, everything basically except for floral. Floral is its own category, and then the decor is aisle runners and centerpieces and furniture and napkins and anything that you know, if you have some special Disney themed something that you want there. Anything outside of floral that is a pretty for your wedding, that's pretty much going to fall under decor. So that covers, or that goes into your event minimum. I mentioned the floral, that's your bouquet, your boutonnieres. If you have floral arrangements at the altar or down the aisle, those count towards your floral. Photography and video services are another thing that go into this event minimum. That's if you have a photographer, videographer, if you do a portrait session inside one of the parks, all of those things go towards your event minimum. You can also have entertainment, which is, you know, immediately you think, you know, bands, DJs, that kind of thing. Those do count, but also you can have Disney characters show up to make an appearance at your reception. They cannot be at your actual wedding, and like, Mickey's not gonna perform your wedding and stuff, so like, don't get that magical idea in your mind. He doesn't do that. But you can have Disney characters show up at your reception to congratulate you and hang out with your guests for a little bit. That can be a thing. You can have trumpeters if you want to announce the bride coming down the aisle, or, you know, whatever you decide to do there. Confetti cannons, anything that is just entertainment for the guests or for you, whatever. All of those things do count. And then the last part of that is the transportation. If you want to have Cinderella's coach, or you want to have the fancy little old, like Rolls Royce or whatever, the old fancy car pull you up to your wedding or take you away to your reception, those things do count as well. All of that being breezed through and talking about what these event minimums, you know, what contributes to that, I'm going to go through and just really quickly mention the different places that you have within each bracket of minimums. The days of the week and the time of day are going to contribute to those minimums. So the middle of the week kind of days are going to be cheaper than a weekend. So the, you know, a Saturday event at noon is probably going to cost closer to the, it's going to be like the $15,000 minimum, whereas a Tuesday afternoon ceremony or reception might only be the $5,000 minimum. So that's what these minimum ranges are, is you're going from the less desirable days and times to the most desired days and times. So that's what the range is. So the lowest one is $5,000 to $15,000, and each one of these locations has a $2,500 venue fee for all of them. So those four locations are the Conch Key Marina at the Grand Floridian, Luau Beach at the Polynesian, Luau Point also at the Polynesian, and Sago Cay at the Grand Floridian. Those are all outdoor locations at those two deluxe resorts outside of the Magic Kingdom. The next bracket is $7,000 to $17,000 for the event minimums. Those venues come with a $4,500 venue fee. Most of these are in Epcot, so I'm gonna run through them real quick. You have the Bonsai Garden in Japan, the Terrace in Canada outside of where the Niagara Falls waterfall is, the China Pavilion Courtyard, the Waterfront in the France Pavilion, the German Courtyard, the Isola in Italy, which is out on the water by the little gondola area, you know, that little section that kind of juts out into the lagoon, the Plaza in Italy, which is obviously back inside the pavilion, the Morocco Pavilion, Tamu Tamu, which is in Harambe in Animal Kingdom, so that one's not in Epcot, and then the UK Courtyard and the UK Pavilion. So those are all the ones between $7,000 and $17,000 for the event minimums, and all of those do come with a $4,500 venue fee. The next bracket, $8,000 to $20,000, has a $4,000 venue fee, and those include the Casitas Courtyard at Coronado Springs, the Croquet Lawn at the Boardwalk Inn, Destino Plaza at Coronado Springs, the Wedding Gazebo at the Yacht Club, Oak Manor at the Port Orleans Riverside Resort, Seabreeze Point, which is the little pagoda area outside of the boardwalk, and Shipwreck Beach, which is outside of the Yacht and Beach Club. The Wedding Pavilion is actually its own category. It has a $10,000 to $15,000 minimum expenditure requirement, and it is a $5,000 ceremony fee. That's the only one that's in that category, so that's what that is. And the next category then is a couple of other specialty in-park locations. Those go from $15,000 to $25,000 event minimums, and like the other in-park locations in Epcot, they have a $4,500 venue fee. Those are the Tower of Terror and the Tree of Life, both of which are between $15,000 and $25,000 for the event minimums. The final bracket, you're probably going, where's the Magic Kingdom? I know that you can get married in the Magic Kingdom. That is the final bracket. That is the biggest bracket. That runs from $20,000 to $50,000 for the event minimums. And this location, the Magic Kingdom, is a little bit different because the venue fees are not all the same for the three locations. The others in each individual bracket, there was one venue fee for all of the venues that were in that section, that bracket of pricing. There's three options for Magic Kingdom weddings. The first is the East Garden in the Hub, right out in front of the castle, and that is a $25,000 venue fee. The other Magic Kingdom option is the train station. If you want to get married down on Main Street at the train station, that is a $15,000 venue fee. And the final Magic Kingdom option is after hours. It's after park close. And that comes with a $30,000 venue fee. So you can get married in front of the castle, or you can get married on the train station, which is also still kind of in front of the castle because, like, you can see down Main Street. But anyway, so those are your options for getting married in the Magic Kingdom. And like I said, that does have a $20,000 to $50,000 event minimum, depending on which location you are at, what time of day, and what day of the week that you are having these events. Okay, so that's me like sprinting through the pricing and everything. I mentioned before, I will link the website down below, so if you want to look at this in more detail to see what party sizes can be accommodated at each venue and those kinds of things, check that out. Make sure that you are getting all of that information that you need, especially if you are planning on having a Disney wedding. So if you do have questions, make sure that you ask those down below, and I will try to get back to you on everything that I know how to answer. And if I don't know the answer, then I will once again direct you to the Disney Fairy Tale Weddings website, because they are really good about getting back to you about stuff and answering questions that you have. So if you are planning a Disney wedding, congratulations. If you're planning any kind of wedding, congratulations. If you were going to get married at Disney, prices be darned, what place would you want to get married? Let me know down below, because I think I would still want to get married at the wedding pavilion. I don't know, there's something about it, but let me know what y'all's picks would be if money was no object, and you, whether you're married already or you plan on never being married, whatever, just let me know which location you would like to have your special day at. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye, y'all.